Let's recap for you. Let's go to the satellite and radar. I want to show you where we're at right now. Temperatures, you know, we've warmed up. We've tried to warm up a little bit, but all that cloud cover and that rain just hasn't done too much for us. 45 mile per hour winds with a storm moving to the north at 14. It will continue to pull away. This is the concern now, a couple of showers and storms, but training like what we're seeing right here. You see, just north and west of Lakeland, that line's going to continue for a while. Could actually build a little bit further to the south, just east of Plant City. So we'll watch for that. There are a couple little showers that we're watching coming towards downtown. There's Amalie Arena right there. So you can see there is a little bit of moisture moving by, but rain chance will be slim. I do think there'll be one or two passing showers. It won't last long at all. Southern Sarasota County, Eastern Manatee. Boy, oh boy, did it rain last night there. Some places close to a foot. There east, north and east of I-75 where it turns down there. This is a 36-hour loop. There it is as a tropical storm. There it goes as a hurricane, Cat 1, 75 mile per hour winds down to 70, 65, made landfall right there in the Big Bend area as we went through earlier this morning. Now you can see right now we don't have much going on out there. Look at the rainfall totals. That's where I was talking about, that very heavy stretch of rain. Nearly a foot of rainfall. And then look here, I mean, Hudson. Weeky watchy area. There's some spots there. It's almost 9-10 inches of rainfall. Official numbers, we've got anywhere from 5 to 10. These are the higher numbers. Most areas along the coast saw about 3 to 5 inches. Areas inland saw a little bit less than that. Just depends on exactly where you were. Winds are still out of the south and the west. We've got sustained winds in the 20s. Some areas, gusts in the mid to upper 20s. 25 mile per hour gusts at Davis Islands last hour. Peak gusts since midnight. 52 in St. Pete, 35 in Sarasota. Sarasota had a 54 mile per hour wind gust. Now the winds were a little bit lower and the southwest wind, which really didn't kick in. This is the water level near the port, near Tampa Bay, the port of Tampa Bay where the cruise ships are. You can see this is about 3:34 in the morning where the water level really started coming up. And then at about 10:30 in the morning, it peaked. It should have been here due to the tides, just normal tides. That's about a 2 foot difference. Most of the locations that I've looked at as far as storm surge go, were around 2 feet or so. Some were just over it. Most were just a little less than 2 feet. So really good news. That's why we showed you there earlier with Liz out at Shore Acres. Some good news for those folks. I'm glad everybody got prepared because we kind of dodged it on this one. The winds will decrease through the evening hours tonight. Stay out of the south and southwest. Isolated shower overnight tonight. That's about midnight, so we'll keep that in the forecast. But southwest winds continue, and that does give us an onshore flow, which means a few showers in the morning. That's 7 o'clock in the morning. We'll keep those through about lunchtime, and then things will push off towards inland locations. Now, Friday, we're going to get back to normal. This is 8 o'clock in the morning. Showers and storms start inland. Come back to the coast in the late afternoon. Let's just get back to our typical summertime weather, right? I think that's what it's going to do, not only for Friday, but for the upcoming weekend. So heading out to the game tonight, watch parties, whatever you're doing. 81 degrees, passing showers there. I gave it a 30% chance. That's probably high. It'll certainly be breezy, but it's coming down. But it is going to stay muggy. The dew points are real high with all of this moisture, and that's not going to change too much. Tomorrow, we're going to go about 89 for a daytime high. Rain chance 50 to 60% in the morning. And then as the afternoon wears on, it actually gets drier because of the southwest flow. So, yeah, the afternoon will be a little bit better. And there's your seven-day forecast. Let's get a quiet weekend here. Boat parade time, I'm not sure. Friday, Saturday, I would like to have it on Saturday. More folks can get out there. Afternoon showers and storms pushing back towards the coast, so it looks really good. And, oh, Allison, there's no other waves in the tropics that we are monitoring right now.
That is what we like to hear, definitely.